Hi, I am Ida Bashkin Martin. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss with you the regions of the abdominal pelvic cavity. Please make sure to click the subscribe button below to be the first to know when I release new videos. We will describe the four quadrants and nine regions and identify them on anatomical models. We will discuss the organs found in these divisions. Purpose of dividing abdominal pelvic cavity to quadrants and regions is able to describe the regional anatomy and help professionals to use precise description of the location of the pathology and determine which organs are involved according to which regions the patient is experiencing the pain or the pathology. Now we have an illustration. Let's focus on the illustration called with the B, abdominal pelvic quadrants. As you may see, the abdominal pelvic region divided to four pieces. The four quadrants defined by the planes, sagittal plane, lines from the xiphoid process of the sternum and vertically approach to pubic bone, and a horizontal plane that passed through the navel or umbilicus. So according to either in patient's right side or left side, we will call it right or left. We will start to describe these quadrants with their side name of the side, right or left. And secondly, we will look is it above or below the horizontal plane. If it is above, we will call upper. If it is below, we will call lower. So let's see. We have right upper quadrant. As you see, there is always abbreviation because in the clinic we mostly use abbreviation. Nobody has so much time to use as a right upper quadrant. Instead, we write RUQ. It's the first letters of the words, so those three words. And we have left upper quadrant, LUQ. We have right lower quadrant, RLQ, and left lower quadrant, LLQ. You may see the organs in these quadrants in the illustration B, but let's discuss. In the right upper quadrant, the right portion of the liver, gallbladder, right kidney, a small portion of stomach, portions of the ascending and transverse colon, and parts of the small intestine. Right lower quadrant, cecum, appendix, part of the small intestines, the right female reproductive organs, and the right ureter. Left upper quadrant has the left portion of the liver, the larger portion of the stomach, the pancreas, left kidney, spleen, portions of the transverse and descending colon, and parts of the small intestine. Lastly, the left lower quadrant houses majority of the small intestine, some of the large intestine, the left female reproductive organs, and the left ureter. If we want to be more precise when we are describing a pathology, then we need to use an alternate system to divide the abdominal pelvic region. Now we will focus on the illustration labeled with the A, abdominal pelvic nine region. Nine regions marked by two parasagittal planes that they're passing from the midclavicular line and the two horizontal planes. I would suggest to learn from the first regions. You need to learn an umbilical region, and when we are considering the nine region, because it's the easiest one. umbilicus, meaning navel, so it found around the umbilicus in the middle. You may consider this like a three columns and three rows, right? And totally nine division. And the region above the umbilical region is called epigastric, and below called hypogastric. Epigastric meaning above the stomach, hypogastric meaning below the stomach. And when we look to right and left side of this middle column, we will call always right. We'll start with the right or left when we describe these regions. And if it is just under, just below the ribs, then we will call right or left hypochondriac regions. And in the lateral side of the body, and the middle row, we will call right or left lumbar region. Some authors use right and left lateral regions instead of lumbar region. And lastly, the inferior or bottom row, we have right and left iliac regions. Some authors describe this as a right and left inguinal region, because there is inguinal ligament in this area. And hypogastric region has another name, pubic region. It's not a pelvic, but it is a pubic region because there is pubic bone here. And organs, you can see it's more precise. And one thing I want to mention, right iliac region or right inguinal region, generally if there's a pain here, it refers to appendicitis, because appendix found in the right iliac region. Let's test our knowledge. You see a photo of the anatomical model that we use in labs, and an illustration labeled with number 4. Label with the number four region label on the anatomical model as well. What is the name of this region? That is one out of the 9 region we called right lateral or right lumbar region. Did you notice it's patient's right, not our right? And if you enjoy this content, feel free to press the like button, and if you like to subscribe, click the subscribe button as well to be informed first to whenever I release any videos. Hope to see you in another video. Bye.